Hey guys, welcome to the very first Danger Doubt video. I am super stoked to be here. I am wired to inspire the fire out of you. And first and foremost, I just want to say that it is a super brave thing to reach out to me, and I feel super blessed reading your guys' emails, knowing that you guys are seeking help, because the first step is always admitting it. Okay? And always talking to somebody about it. You can never just bottle it up inside. So I want to applaud those who have sent me emails on their danger doubts, because I know doubt is such a heavy burden on your heart and you need to let it out. And I really appreciate you guys, and you guys are such brave souls. You guys are danger soldiers. D-A-N-G-E-R. They all need good energy, right? I want to show you guys how to be anywhere and to be around anyone and never, ever, ever let them shake your energy, because you can do this. Taesty advice I'm going to give you is something that I would do as if I was in your situation. So by all means, take it or leave it, whatever you want to do, but this is something I am offering to you. It is a gift to you. I'm only offering you guys advice. So with that being said, let us begin. Danger doubt one. I'm going through a situation that involves my sanity. I find myself feeling lost, and some people, I'm shutting them out, mainly avoiding attachment because a lot of people in my life that I've cared deeply about have left due to life. I know I should be used to it and move on with my life, but it makes it hard for me to let go. So when it comes to being close to someone recently, I back off. When I see them, I hide from them. I don't know what to do. So it seems to me that your mind is living in the past. And you keep remembering all the bad things that have happened to you, all the people that have left you for whatever reasons. And because you keep remembering that, your energy is focused there, and whatever you focus on magnifies. So what's gonna happen is, when you keep focusing on the past of the hardships and the pain, you bring that into your future, because your power is in the now. Your mind is a very powerful tool, and you have to control it before it tries to control you. What's happening is, you're creating all that in the now. You're thinking about it, so you're recreating it, and it's gonna come in a different form of new faces, AKA different people, different friends that may leave you. So that's what you're dealing with now. That is the fear in you that is making you feel that way, and that is making you back off of people. What I would do, I would just know that piece of information. Okay, I'm dwelling on the past, so obviously it's creating my future with different people, and I wanna stop this. And I would stop and ask myself, what do I want? What do I want? Forget the past, forget the future. What do I want right now? And when I think of friends, and when I think of like family and lovers, like, what do I want? Me? I wanna feel loved. I wanna feel loved, but I don't wanna have to depend on anybody to love me. I wanna feel loved by myself. And once I get that strength in me, then I want to attract those who have that same strength, those who could feel loved independently, those who could feel happy independently, because I want to feel happy. I would first and foremost let go of that past. I know it's super hard, but you're letting go of that past because you were a prisoner of that past, and you owe it to yourself. So you don't have to necessarily physically go talk to each person in your past and forgive them. No, you could forgive them right here, right now. Just forgive them in energy. You know, I forgive you guys for A, B, C, and D, but it doesn't mean I have to let you guys in my life again. I'm gonna respect whatever happened, the bridges burned, whatever happened, happened. And I'm focused on the now and the new friendships and the new lovers and the new life and the happiness that I wanna attain right now. I'm free of the past, boom, done. And now my whole thing is, I want to create my future. So obviously I understand that whatever my mind focuses on, then it comes about. So I'm going to stop focusing on the past, and I'm going to start focusing on what I want. If I were you, I would grab a piece of paper and write down all the characteristics of what I want in a friend and all the characteristics of what I want in a lover. And circle them and highlight them and read them and feel them. Like, I want to have good times with them. I want to dork out with them. I want to be my full self with them. I want them to love me for me. I want to just have so much fun with them. I want to go on adventures with them. I want to build forts. I want to play video games. I want to eat crazy junk food. I want to make jokes. I want to make memories. I want to take pictures. I want to post them on my IG to show that we are gangsta. I want to just have so much fun. But do you see how I started talking about it? I started like cheesing. My dork smile came up. Yeah. That's what you gotta feel. I just felt that energy come over me. And when you feel that, you gotta be excited that it's here already. You gotta be excited, like, hey, forget the past. What's happening right now is, I feel so excited that I have these friends that are coming my way. I have this lover that's coming my way. I have this happiness that's here now. And I can have that without it even being here. And that's the great part of attracting what you want. And the main thing you always gotta remember is nothing is more important than that you feel good. So if your past or certain thoughts are making you feel bad, you're only like blocking yourself from your own happiness. So the way you destroy that is letting go and focusing on the things that make you happy. And when you do that, those new faces aren't gonna walk out of your life. Those new faces are gonna wanna stay because they are the exact match to what you wrote down and what you feel. That I call energy. When you guys are on that same frequency, his energy, her energy, and your energy are like the same energy, like attracts like, positive, positive, like attracts like, and you guys will get to play those video games. You guys will get to make those forts. You guys will get to make those jokes, post some IG pictures. You guys will have the time of your life. All you gotta do is have faith. And when you have faith and redirect your mind to what you want, you will be happy. But you gotta be happy first that you already have it. That's what faith's all about. So the one thing from my experience that I've learned is that people come and go. People come and go and it has nothing to do with you. That's just part of life. Some people grow together and some people grow apart, and that's just it, and it has nothing to do with you. I've learned that I've outgrown people, or some people, you know, fall off my frequency, and instead of forcing them to be in my life and thinking something's wrong with me, I just simply understand that that is a part of life and that I need to fully accept it, because we're humans. We're allowed to grow apart, we're allowed to grow together, we're allowed to do anything. We have free will, and you cannot make someone stay in your life if they no longer match you. Once I was okay with letting those friends go or those lovers go, and I just kept my joy, my happiness, and my understanding and my peace, better people came along the way. Better people came into my life, better lovers, better friends, better adventures. So you have something great to look forward to, my man. And I just wanted to say thank you so much, Jack, for sharing your story with us. You not only helped yourself grow, but you helped me grow, and you helped a million others grow, because I guarantee you that you are not the only one going through this problem. I went through it, and I bet you hundreds of other kids are going through it as well. So I applaud you, my man. Thank you so much for your bravery. You guys, I really hope you enjoyed the very first Danger Dout video. For all my other taste buds, I am inviting you to write to me personally about your personal Danger Dout. Again, I could drop your name or leave it anonymous. It's totally up to you, and I completely respect that. My email address is below. Rahar. Hold on. I'm gonna make it appear like magic. You ready? Boom. I am Taesty Danger at iCloud.com. So feel free to write to me anytime. Again, your name can remain anonymous or known. It's completely up to you. And I look forward to reading your emails. Bless you, child.